Hi, I'm Linda Johnson Robb from Reading is Fundamental, and this is the Rosie O'Donnell Show. On today's show, Jennifer Love Hewitt, Gloria Estefan, a 95-year-old McDonald's employee, Gladus Wagner, and Vitamin C. Hit it, John! Hurry.
Well, we're a cut above because we got Jennifer Love.
It's the Rosie O'Donnell Show.
Great to see you. Rosetta Lenoir is here, ladies and gentlemen. The one and only. You look beautiful.
You look good.
Oh, good to see you. I'll talk to you at the commercial.
All right.
Okay.
God
All right.
Bless
God bless you, too. Sit down. Don't stand for me. Ever. Don't ever stand for me, Rosetta. How are you?
Oh,
lovely
Rosie.
To meet you. Come on down here so I don't look so short next to you. How are you?
Wonderful.
You're here to tell us all about RIF, Reading is Fundamental.
Yes, I'm the chairman of Reading is Fundamental, and we are very excited. By the year 2000, we will have given away 200 million books to children.
Wow! How about that? That's an amazing accomplishment.
Well, we don't do it alone. We have the help of 250,000 RIF volunteers, and we have the help of Lean Cuisine. Thanks to Lean Cuisine's Lean On Me campaign, which was just last month, Lean Cuisine is going to give us $217,000, and that will help
us. Wow, that's great. Can I just tell you that you have the best elocution and pronunciation of anyone who has ever been on the show? It's so perfect.
Well, I read a lot to children, and you know, they are very demanding.
Exactly.
And you see, I'm bringing you a book today. This was made to celebrate RIF's 25th anniversary. And here is a good story for you to get your children to read to you.
Okay.
Taking Care of Rosie.
There you go. Or as my son says, Rosie is a show.
Yes.
That's what he says. This is my mama. Rosie is a show. I thank you very much. It's lovely to have you here.
We thank you, Rosie.
No sweat.
Thank you.
And thanks to Lean Cuisine.
Thank
my pleasure.
You.
Say hello to John McDee, the McDee LT. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
How's it going?
It's going great.
Good weekend?
Great weekend.
What'd you do?
I was getting in the holiday, the Halloween spirit, preparing for a concert I'm going to do next weekend in Utah, Salt Lake City, with the Utah Symphony. It's all Halloween stuff, Sweeney Todd and Psycho and cool music. It's
excellent.
Fun. I can't wait.
Have you been carving any pumpkins?
I have not, but I've been waiting for your lesson, actually.
Well, I asked the prop department to get me a pumpkin, and look what they chose. Something that is dented in the back right here.
Right.
And nice. Has some really problem areas on the front, if you take a look at that right there.
Yeah.
I decided I would try anyway, since a lot of you people don't have the chance to get a perfect pumpkin. I spend 3 or 4 good hours every weekend at the pumpkin patch looking for the perfect carving pumpkin.
Yep.
When you look at the pumpkin you're going to carve, you should be able to see the face in it.
Oh, that's good. That's
be
good.
Be the rock.
Indeed.
That's what you should do. All right, so today I'm going to go through the steps. We're going to do one thing every day.
Wonderful.
Get a large knife. Here's what I say. And I'm going to show you. Up camera. I'm going to show you the carving. We're going to start at the beginning, all right?
Perfect.
Get your pumpkin, ladies. Get your big knife. Here's my big advice.
Okay.
Go in towards, on an angle like this, in towards the center of the pumpkin.
All right.
See what I'm doing? I'm not doing this.
Nope.
No, I'm doing this, in towards the center.
Right.
Why are you doing that, Rosie, you might say?
Hmm.
Well, because it makes it much easier to keep the lid on. Here's what I do. I do one long way. See this? I made one slice.
Right.
Now I'm going to go in again towards the center. And length of the knife.
Wow.
Again, towards the center.
Right.
And length of the knife.
There we go.
Towards the center, length of the knife. And then you connect the dots at the end, so,
right.
And look,
oh my.
Off it comes.
Just like that. Perfect.
You then take your knife and make sure to cut along so you get that part out, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Now, what? This fits exactly.
Perfectly.
You know people who do the little jig-jag? Mm-hmm. You can never see what goes where.
Right.
This, four little slices.
It's clear.
And
right.
Notice they're sort of inward, because the right. pointing of the knife towards the center.
Exactly.
And now, ladies, you're ready to go.
Wow.
What I'd like you to do overnight is to carve, take the stuff out of the middle. What I like to do is to go along the ridge here so that you have a nice clean edge, to go about a half an inch into the pumpkin meat, so to speak, and there you go. Take all the stuff out. See what I just did?
Right.
All that junk should be removed, and tomorrow we're gonna do eyebrows. All righty,
cool.
There you have it, ladies.
Good. That's good stuff to know.
You know, John, when you're good at something, you just have to share it,
That's
frankly.
That's very true. Very true.
You notice my haircut? Decoupage accident. Don't want to talk about
you
it.
You are kidding.
Okay.
Did you really?
Don't
no.
want to talk about it.
Did
no,
you?
I'm not going to discuss it.
Oh, my.
Just let me say this. The two-part resin coating, not as easy as it looks.
Okay.
That's all I want to say.
Okay.
You know what I'm doing tonight, John?
Yeah.
I'm throwing a big, huge party.
Yes.
I'm not throwing it, actually. Fran Weisler is throwing it.
Right.
Broadway salutes Hillary Clinton.
That's right.
Hillary Clinton is going to be our next senator. Did you
that's
know
true.
That?
That's true.
She is from the state
that's
of New York.
Fantastic.
Did you happen to watch the World Series?
Sure did.
Did you see that Pizza Hut commercial?
Didn't miss it. Uh-huh.
Was not enjoyable to me.
Not nice.
They were making fun of the first
lady. What is that?
I don't know. Just like to say that I'm stopping at Domino's on the way home.
That's good. That'll be good.
Got a little something to say to Pizza Hut. Wrote a little song about it. Want to hear it? Here go. If you want pizza good and cheesy, don't call Pizza Hut, they're sleazy. Their ads blow! Call Domino's! I'm mad because their ads are shady. They mess with the fine first lady. What crust? No go! Call Domino's! Cause Domino's is the boss and they got good sauce and their price is fair and they got cheese to spare. Take one home tonight, cause they're more polite than those putty nut schmoes. I said that wrong. I cannot state it more emphatically. Hot pies undemocratically have to go. So listen to me and call Domino's.
Well, you know.
That's not fair of them,
shady.
Is it?
Yeah, I don't think so.
That's not fair, and I do enjoy Domino's pizza,
good
by
stuff.
The way. Good stuff.
Yes,
oh, yeah.
Indeed.
Do you know Robert Kennedy was a senator from New York?
Oh.
Yes.
Yeah.
Born and raised in Massachusetts.
Massachusetts.
Lived his whole life in Massachusetts.
Oh, yeah.
Served our state well.
Very well.
Just thought I'd bring that up.
That's
okay.
Good thing to remember.
Democrat. What a surprise. Listen, the thing about Breast Cancer Month is that it's this month, and we have GM Concept Cure. Wonderful organization, General Motors. They're trying to really to eradicate breast cancer.
Right.
They're trying to find a cure, raise money, and they've given millions and millions and millions of dollars. Right. Here's the phone number right here, GM Concept Cure, that you can phone. Here it is, right there. It's coming up soon.
There we go.
Oh, well, no, it is. Yeah,
1-888-GM-CURE,
and that's a Dana Buckman automobile that she actually decorated and designed. And when you call and make a donation to Concept Cure, you're entered to win one of the designer decorator GM cars, including cool. that one right there. Cool. So call that number, make a donation, all right? All right. I found two cameras in my house, and they were, you know, full of empty film, those little portable, you know, the little ones you get all in one.
Sure.
And I thought, I don't remember using these.
Uh-huh.
And I developed them, and I got doubles made because, you know, you never know.
Sure.
I could have forgotten. It could
yeah.
have been something great. And frankly, they're all like this. My son took the camera from my, look, he took the camera from, look at this, a great one of me. Look at that. That's nice, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
That's a good one. And here's the like best shot of the entire roll. There you go. And I have doubles of everything, just in case you wanted to know.
So you're covered.
Doubles. Yeah, that's nice, isn't it? I'm like, did
right.
you take pictures? Lies through his teeth. I did not, Mama. I go, it's funny, because I don't think that anyone else in this family would just frame my knees.
Exactly. What's that?
And my daughter's making me insane. She's 2 years old, and she wants to do everything herself.
Really?
And I'm finally myself screaming at a baby. She was wanting to do the nail polish. She's two, you know what? I got 36 years on this kid. You know what I mean?
Right.
She wants to put her nail polish, the Q-tip, in the nail polish remover, but I can't let her do that because it goes all over
the
place.
Right?
So I just give her one that's wet with water, but she figures it out. She smells it. This is not it, Mama.
Oh.
I'm like, oh, Einstein, you have to be my child, you know? So then I'm like, she's like, Chelsea, do it. I'm like, Mama, do it. She's like, Chelsea, do it. I'm like, Mama, do it. She's like, Chelsea, do it! And I'm thinking, what is wrong with me? I'm looking at her face going, Mama, do it! Mama, do it! And she's looking at me like this. And she's two! Can you imagine when she's 12?
Oh, no.
The kid, she's gonna be married with four kids by the time she's 12. She's like, she's so advanced, it's frightening.
Wow.
My son at two would just sit there and do whatever. I remember at a party when he was two, his friend's party, he picked up a rock, literally. He was across the lawn. He lifted up a rock. He was considering possibly throwing at someone.
Right.
I was eating pasta. I saw it in the corner of my eye. I went like this. He put the rock down.
Right.
Chelsea, I have to go, give it to Mommy! Give it to Mommy!
Wow.
It's like
that's
insane.
So severe.
I'm losing my mind.
Oh, my Lord.
And now I just hurt my throat.
Oh,
I need
some
Domino's pizza. Somebody order me some.
That's right.
You know, we're going to buy Domino's pizza tonight at the Hillary Clinton
oh,
benefit.
Oh, cool. Perfect.
Yeah, I'm going to buy it. I'm splurging.
I can't wait.
I'm getting 2,000 pies just to say, hey, Pizza Hut. Whatever.
That's
making
great.
It great, my hiney. Anyway, they're going to be mad at me, but frankly, I don't care. Because why should I? I had to get my hair cut because of a decoupage accident, and life is really too short to care about the little things.
Indeed.
You know, I wrote a book.
Yes.
I didn't really write it. I just wrote the comedy. My breast doctor, my boob lady, she wrote it, and I added the comedy, and it's called Bosom Buddies. And I thought instead of just singing my own mammogram song today, I'd make her do it with me because she hates to do it.
Right.
But, you know, I had to write a book, and I've never done that, so fair is fair.
It's
please
true.
Welcome Dr. Deborah Axelrod. Thank you very much. She said I was great with the knife. I'd be a good surgeon, don't you think?
Excellent.
Yeah, did you get a haircut too? Look at how short you are there.
I did.
You did. Who did that? Yourself?
My kid's barber.
They did? Really? You went to a barber? Deborah, you're one of the top surgeons in the country. You go to a barber to get a haircut? I don't think that your patients are going to be filled with trust when they look at that hair. They go, look at that hair. How's she going to cut my boob open? Look at that hair. No, it's all right. It's fine. Look at
thank you.
Accent. So did you hear about our books doing well?
Yeah, it's a bestseller.
Thanks to your parents, right?
Thanks
tell
to
everybody
my parents.
What your parents do. Tell everyone, Deb.
Well, Ann and Murray, they go to the health section in the bookstores, and they bring out the books, and they put it in the bestseller section in the front.
Yeah. All in the tri-state area, it's a bestseller because of her parents
it's
going
great.
To every mall in the tri-state area.
Great.
Let's have a round of applause for your parents. Now, I know that you have a website up. You have a website. You showed it to me. I was bored to tears, but it's very informational. No, because I know all the stuff, but tell everybody where the website is.
It's an educational website, and you can log on to www.breastdoc.com.
And that's you. You'd be Breast Doc.
I'm the Breast Doc.
There you go, breastdoc.com. Would you like to sing a little song with me, Deborah?
You embarrass me.
I know. I do. I know. But, you know, I figure you got to loosen up your image. You got to get a little more savvy, a little more fun.
I'm not fun.
Not really, no. You're not. But you're a very good breast doctor. I wouldn't put my boobs in anyone else's hands. Good night! All right. Here we go. Take it, John. Ready? Hey, ladies out there, get out of that chair.
Take heed and take care.
Check your boobies. Go test this and that. It's like tit for tat.
And just nothing flat.
Check your boobies. Why not bring a friend, save a buddy? Take it.
Just move your rear end, fuddy-duddy.
That's pretty good. Remember, these are not silly putty. Wah, wah.
Kick body.
Wah, wah. Check boobies. So call your MD, show your B's and your C's.
To beat the disease, you should go.
Oh, a good note. It's twice as nice when you're in the vice, so take this doctor's healthy advice.
Go check them,
protect them, don't neglect them. Jennifer Love Hewitt. interactive Monday because our new AOL website is finally up. Hip, hip, hooray. It took forever, but we're up. So keyword Rosie on America Online and chat with us during the show. I know what our next guest did last summer. She left my favorite show, Party of Five, and started to work on her own series, Time of Your Life, which premieres tonight on Fox. Please welcome back to the show, cutie patootie, Jennifer Love Hewitt.
I'm good. How are you?
Good to see you.
Nice to see you, too.
It was very sad leaving Party of Five.
I know.
The train station.
I know.
What's going on?
The goodbye.
I know. Are you going to make guest appearances at least for me?
I don't know.
You don't know.
I don't know what they're going to do. No. I don't know. But the new one airs tonight, so that's good.
Yeah. And, you know, I hear you have a guest star.
Yeah. And actually, you know, the guest star got a very good review in the New York Times today.
Really? No
kidding. Yes. What does it say? It says Rosie O'Donnell. We all know who that is.
Yeah.
Has a cameo in tonight's episode as the receptionist, who may be Sarah's real father, and she's adorably obnoxious.
Adorably obnoxious? I think that's the best review I've ever received in my life. Usually they just write obnoxious. They leave out
the
adorable.
Well, because her character is kind of mean to me.
Yeah, I am. We have a
but
clip.
But you were adorable. Good.
Let's shut up the clip.
Okay, good.
Now you go to look for your dad, because
yes.
you're adopted.
Yes.
And you go to look for your dad in New York City.
And he's this big time guy. And
producer guy.
Yes,
and I'm
you're
his secretary.
Receptionist.
Okay.
Yes.
Take a look.
Okay.
Alrighty. Well, will he know what this is in reference to?
No.
No. Okay. Well, can I tell him what it's in reference to?
Actually, it's a personal matter, and it would be better if I could talk to him myself.
Alrighty. Just leave your picture and resume right here in this box. Thanks a lot.
No, I'm not an actress.
Of course you're not.
Look, I have something that I really need to talk to him about. Okay, it's important for both of us.
Okay, well, why don't you leave your number? He's going to a benefit tonight at Lincoln Center. Then tomorrow, he's off to Moscow for a cultural exchange. Maybe I'll phone you when he gets back. Not promising. Stranger things have happened. She was good, whoever that actress was. It's so funny because I haven't acted in a long time. I was nervous.
Well, it was a dream come true for me, and I thank you so much
well,
for doing it.
Well, you're more than welcome.
Really.
We did it in 20 minutes upstairs.
It was awesome.
And you're shooting it here in New York, right?
Yeah.
That must be great for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, we got to shoot a little bit. It was really, really fun. I got hit by a cab.
You did?
Yeah, I did. New York is a very, very friendly. Yeah, I was standing in a driveway, and we were getting ready to shoot a scene. I was just standing on my mark before they were, like, fixing up hair and makeup, and this cab, like, was trying to go in the driveway, and me, I was like, ooh, I said, hold on just a second. I'm just standing on my mark. It'll be just a minute. And he was ready to go, so he just, like, nailed me in the leg.
Are you kidding? Really? Were you hurt?
No, I was fine. I was fine. It was just sort of shocking.
Yeah. Now, you're not shooting the whole show in New York.
No, just part of it.
Parts of it,
Just part of it.
Who's
but
the
I love
cute
New
boy
York.
Who's on it?
Jonathan Scheck plays
yes.
Mubarak. Yeah.
And he was in That Thing You Do?
Wait, uh-huh.
Yes, that's where I saw
Yeah, he's amazing.
Yeah, he's
Yeah,
good.
He's really good.
And he's going to be your love interest?
Kind of, sort of. Sarah, we're not really doing love interest stuff right away because she's still, you know, with Bailey and
well,
stuff.
Well, do you ever mention Bailey on the new show?
We do. And and there's answering machine messages from Bailey that are very sweet.
Really?
Yes, and
oh,
Sarah leaves messages for Bailey on Party of Five, so that's
good. That's enjoyable to me.
Yes.
I don't enjoy when someone leaves the show and goes to another show
no.
and then pretends we and don't realize.
And they forget. I know.
Excuse me.
I know.
What about Benton's girlfriend, the mother of his child, goes to Ally McBeal and just forgets, oh, I had a baby with Benton? You know, it's very disturbing to me, the home viewer. It's like when they switched Darren's. We knew what they were doing, love.
I know. So we keep a connection there.
Now, are you nervous? Because when they called you in to tell you about your own series, you told me you thought that they were going to fire you.
Yeah. Well, I had never been called into, like, a serious meeting by Chris and Amy before. I mean, normally, like, they'd call and say, you know, how you doing? How you feeling? Everybody treating you good? And I was like, yeah, okay. And they called me in for a meeting, and I was like, oh, my God, I'm so fired right now. They're going to kick me off Party of Five.
Right.
Well, they did, but they kicked me off for a good reason, so
yeah,
it ended up
show.
Okay.
Do you feel pressure that you have to carry a whole show sort of now?
I'm kind of nervous.
A little nervous.
But I'm having so much fun, and my main thing that I'm trying to do on the show is just make sure that, like, you guys like it and have a good time and that you're happy. And
as long as you still mention the Salingers.
I promise.
And you don't just forget them.
No, we don't.
Because both their parents died, and he's going to have a lot of scars if you just leave him for
I
that
know.
Jonathan show.
Well, I don't leave him.
Good.
I don't leave him.
Because, you know, Bailey has a little control issue, but he still loves you, Sarah. He loves you.
I know. But Bailey hasn't treated Sarah exactly the best.
I mean, agree.
We need to talk about
I
this.
I agree, and he was sort of a trampy whore
yeah.
guy.
I mean, three girls he cheated. You
understand?
Know. Hello.
You know what? Don't call him now that I think
okay,
about
good.
It. Don't call him at all.
Good.
You stay there with Jonathan Scheck, and you have a good time.
Thank you.
Now, are you going to get to sing
I
on
do.
The show?
My character works in a karaoke bar. How happy am I?
I'm happy because You gave me my karaoke machine.
Yes.
And I actually got one for the show.
Did you?
And you're going to be our first guest to do Rosie-oki. Oh. Just like karaoke, Rosie-oki. We got it with two mics. I can sing with you, but I'm not promising.
Okay, good.
Tell everybody about your scream for Halloween while you're here, quick.
Oh, yes, sing. For the Starlight Foundation to help children, I screamed for Halloween. And you can, right, you can send
you
a
scream.
It is so much fun.
It is
I had
fun
a blast.
I got a couple of them in my email.
Good. Oh, really?
Yeah,
oh,
I did.
Good.
I did.
Cool.
All right, we're going to come back, and Love is going to sing, and you're going to watch the
show
tonight.
She's going to sing, too.
My buddy Gloria Estefan. We're back with Love Hewitt, whose new show premieres tonight on Fox. You better watch it. I'll definitely be watching it.
At 8 o'clock.
At 8 o'clock, I'll get to plug in if you can. Now, you're also a real singer.
Yeah.
You are. And
yes.
You're good.
Thank you.
And you're probably the queen of karaoke.
I love karaoke.
Me too. All right. And I got this karaoke machine here. And you're going to be the first one to do it. Did you choose?
Yes.
You chose?
Put a little love in your heart.
Put a little love in your heart. All right. Here we go.
Woo!
All right, love. Take it.
Okay.
I don't know where it
here
starts.
Here it goes.
Think of your fellow man, lend him a helping hand. Put a little love in your heart.
Oh, you're good!
Go!
Go.
You see, it's getting late. Oh, please don't hesitate.
Yeah.
Put a little love in your heart.
In your heart,
your
in your heart, in your heart.
The world and the world will be a better place. And the world will be a better place for you.
For you.
And me.
Beautiful, beautiful voice.
Oh, thank you.
Oh my gosh. Wow.
Thank you.
And you do all those great little things. What are they called anyway?
Riffs.
They're like, you know, in sync. Or the Backstreet Boys. Are you going to have a record deal, you think? I know you had the other
record. I don't know. Maybe. I'm thinking about it.
I'm telling you. Telling me, tell her. You're watching the show, sign girl up. Watch your program tonight. Next time when you come, we'll do a whole song with the band.
I would love that.
All right. Rosie-oki. Okay. It's much better to do Rosie-oki when people are bowling and you're eating fries. But still, it's kind of enjoyable in the morning. Gloria Estefan up next. Don't go away. Great job. Two-time Grammy Award winner, international singing superstar. This Friday, she makes her film debut with Meryl Streep, hello, in Music of the Heart. Please welcome my friend and yours, Gloria Estefan.
Hey, where's my little footstool?
There's your little footstool right there.
Yes, because I'm so huge.
You are. Actually, a lot of people need it, so don't feel bad.
I don't feel bad.
Oh, good.
I feel short, but not bad.
How are you?
I'm great.
I miss you. I haven't seen you since, you know, summer's over.
The summer. This is the queen of the water. Every time I would drive by the bridge, I'd see your wet bikes out, your boat out. You were really having a blast.
You're not kidding. It's my favorite place, Miami, you know.
Yeah, me too.
I love it so much.
I love it too.
How did we do during the hurricane?
Did you get the fish problem?
I heard about the fish problem. What was...
Well, we had a couple of hurricanes that came through. In fact, the last one that was there, we didn't know we were going through it, and we were in the hurricane. And we only knew because the waves got so high in the backyard in the bay that it would come over the dock. And then, of course, the dock has little slits in it, so the water would leave, and there would be fish there. So all of a sudden we look back, there's a 12-pound snapper back there. I go get it, let's eat the thing so it didn't die in vain at least.
Exactly.
It was too far gone.
And did you have to go throw all the fish back in or get rid of them?
Yeah, we threw them back in.
But oh, that's scary.
That big one, it was a shame, you know, it was too far gone, we couldn't eat it. Yeah. Smelled up the kitchen really bad.
Did you make sure that my house was fine?
Your house was fine.
All right,
I took
good.
Care of it. It was cool, no problem.
And how are the kids, good?
Naib is actually got his first lead in a motion picture. He's going to be shooting in Miami, thank God, in January, so he'll be home for 4 months.
Are you kidding? He's lead?
Yes, he's living out in L.A. He's done a couple little bit parts already, and I'm thrilled. He's studying acting and film. He wants to be a director, so he's doing great. And Emily's great. Emily's here. She's.
I saw her, actually, right there, cutie patootie, with Saatchi's new haircut. Everyone's getting the haircut. Look at you.
Everybody.
How good do you look on the cover of Ocean Drive Mag with your new short hair?
Thank you.
Was it traumatic for you? A lot of people say it's traumatic.
It was not traumatic. I was ready. I wanted to clean out those energies before 2000 comes around.
Exactly.
You know, you hold a lot of energy in your hair. Yours is long.
Yeah,
it's great.
I just got a cut. I had a decoupage accident.
What is this with the decoupage?
You know I'm a good decoupage.
I know, but how could you have an accident? What did you do?
I have a new
coating. Glue your hair to the thing?
Kind of, I did, yes.
Oh, okay.
No, I have a new coating, this polymer. You know how the toy boxes in my house are all with that thick coating?
Yes,
it's
I
hard
know.
To do.
Crafty little
I'm very
thing.
Very crafty.
You could have done great in Psycho, too, when I saw you with that, wielding that knife.
Yeah, I know, I'm good. Are you a good carver of the pumpkins?
I can carve pumpkins.
You
yes,
can.
I can. Yes,
yeah.
I can. I can do that.
Do you just do the triangle eyes or do you do circles?
No circles.
You just do the triangle eyes?
No, but I do different stuff.
Like what?
Well, I do different mouths on the thing, different noses.
But all triangle eyes?
No, no triangle.
Then what do you do for the eyes?
Well, I switch around.
Yeah, do you do the circle with the circle in it with the little dot?
No, I don't do
I'll
that.
Teach you that, Chloe. Don't
all
worry.
Right. Don't flaunt your pumpkin, you know, knowledge at me.
I'm very good. And wait until you see my house at Christmas.
Oh, God. Are you going to compete? I don't do much stuff, okay?
You will this year, because I'm your neighbor, and I'll be calling the Board Association.
Oh.
The Estefans have no Christmas decorations up.
We
can you send someone over there?
No, we have some.
And thank you for being on my Christmas record.
Are you kidding
me? Have you heard it?
I had a blast.
Okay, right, here we go. Here it is. Ready?
There's a twinkle in my eye for a piece of pumpkin pie.
Okay, don't worry, we'll fix it
it's
at the
It's a
commercial.
Surprise, we're not supposed to do it anyway till December.
That's right, but it's coming out November 2nd.
Yes.
And it was really fun, you and me singing
had
Gonna
a blast.
Eat for Christmas.
My first parody I've written and recorded. Well, I've written a million of them, but I actually recorded this parody, so I'm thrilled.
And we had a lot of fun there.
We had a blast.
Now, congratulations on your movie, Music
Thank
of the
you.
Heart.
Yeah.
Meryl Streep, a little intimidated?
You know what? She made it so easy that it was wonderful.
She's
a super warm, loving person. And, I mean, just being with her was easy. She made it all a blast.
Right. And
I expected to be nervous, and I really wasn't. I really felt
it's
good.
You and Meryl and
Angela Bassett.
And Cloris Aidan Quinn.
Aidan Quinn.
And Cloris Leachman. And it's a wonderful story about the woman who teaches violins up in Harlem,
It's a true story about Roberta Gospari. She established a violin program, started with 50 violins, now has 150. And oddly enough, right before the movie finished, before we wrapped it, her program was reinstated. Isn't that a coincidence?
Yeah, what a surprise.
Gee.
Yeah.
How nice.
And we have
10 years it took her to get this thing done.
Exactly. We have a clip.
You do?
Yes. Do you know which clip it is?
No.
This is the first time setting up a movie clip of yours.
Oh, my gosh, yes. Is it the clip where we're on the bench, Marilyn?
Exactly.
Do you know that clip, it was the first scene I ever shot in my life for a movie. It was the first scene in the movie shot, and it's my biggest scene with her. So it was a baptism of fire. There was like, boom, go, do
it. Okay, you're another teacher in the school, and this is one of her first days at work, and she goes and meets Meryl. Music of the Heart, take a listen.
Is it my imagination, or does everybody here hate me?
It's hard to fit in when you're doing a special program. People figure you're not going to be here long, so they don't make the effort. It may take a while for folks to warm up, but they don't hate you.
So why are you being so nice to me?
Ulterior motives. I want my daughter in your class next year.
If I'm here next year.
You will be.
It opens everywhere this Friday, the 29th.
Yeah, you know, my mom's a teacher. She's here, too. My mom's
Your mom's here, too?
My
oh,
mom's
good. I get
here.
To see the whole family.
Yeah, everybody's here for the premiere tomorrow.
Tomorrow, it's here in New York.
Yeah.
I'll go.
All
I can't go.
No.
It's Bette Midler's concert thing.
Oh, I just saw her in Miami.
Yeah, isn't she great?
So good. I love Bette.
And all the benefits go to her restoration project
that's
while
great.
She's here in New York.
That's great.
Yeah. So is it true the story I heard about your 6-year-old daughter fixing the alarm?
Oh, my gosh. It was really freaky because she's just too smart. Like you were saying about kids... So smart. One night we're alone, her and I, in the house. So I'm gonna put the alarm on, and it didn't go on. So I go through the motions, and she's watching me. So I fix it. I go, it says family room. Let's check the family room. We go. There was a window. There was something disconnected. I plug it in. That's it. So 4 days later, she's alone with her nanny at the house, and the nanny can't put the alarm on. So she goes, Jenny, come here. Press that button. She goes, read me what it says. So she goes, family room. She goes, come with me, Jenny. She takes her to the family room. She goes, there's the problem. Plug that in. And Jenny's going, what? Plug it in. She plugs it in. She fixed the alarm. Jenny's freaking out because she didn't know. She's gone through it with me. They're just too smart.
She thought she was a psychic.
Yeah, something strange. Imagine a little girl does that to you. And she's
adorable, your daughter. There she is, playing with my kids all summer. We had the greatest time.
Yeah, it was great.
The movie starts this Friday, and you're going to be in Miami for the Millennium Concert.
Yes, indeed. Yes. We're going to have a huge party there. Close enough to boat or walk in case anything happens. And nothing's going to happen for that Y2K thing. But we're thrilled. Throw a big party.
And it's the opening
jaw-dropping
of a
show.
Brand new arena.
Brand new arena. I hope it doesn't happen like Billy Joel, that they did a brand new arena and nobody could figure out how to turn off the lights. They're all waiting for the show. Nobody could turn
nobody
off the
lights. Nobody knew
how. So we're going to have a few practice sessions.
Well, that'll be good. Gloria, delightful to see you. Music of the Heart opens Friday. Go see it. You're wonderful in it. We'll be right back after this break. And my hair is different. Come on. To meet our next guest today. Born in 1904, the same year the hamburger was invented. Now at the age of 95, she's working at McDonald's. Please welcome Gladus Wagner.
Oh, I'm fine.
Lovely to meet you.
Thank you. I'm very glad to be here.
Now, you would think at 95, Gladus, you'd get to relax and take it easy, not have a job at McDonald's.
Oh, I gotta keep busy.
Yeah.
I really, if I didn't, I wouldn't do anything.
No kidding. How long have you worked at McDonald's?
That's 12 years.
12 years. And what's your job there?
I just talk to the children and wash the dishes. I don't work behind the counter. I refuse to learn the computer.
Oh, really?
Yes,
really.
I told them it cost them more to teach me to do it than it would for them to pay somebody to do it for me, and I will not do it.
No, well, I don't blame you. So you're a hostess?
Yes.
And do you enjoy the food there at McDonald's?
I eat the food there 4 days a week. Otherwise, I don't go there anymore.
No, 4 days a week. What's your favorite there? You get the McNuggets?
Oh, the cheeseburger and
cheeseburger
fries.
And fries, mm-hmm. Yeah.
I hear you like them, too.
You know, I do, actually. I get the quarter pounder with cheese.
Oh, that's too much for me.
Too much for you.
Make me fat.
I've never said that, actually. I've never uttered the words, too much for me. I've never done that, actually, Gladus. No. Now, what did you do before you worked there?
I worked at an optical company for 30 years.
Yeah.
Retired to take care of my mother, who was 96. I was 69 and she was 96. She lived 3 months after I retired.
Right. Well, I bet you were glad to have that time with
her. Yes, I was.
Yeah.
I appreciate it very much.
What do you attribute your long life to, your longevity? You have any hints
on the way I eat.
Oh, yeah.
I eat lots of fruit, lots of vegetables. I don't eat sweets. I don't eat much red meat, only what I eat at McDonald's.
You're a company gal, aren't you?
I really am.
Yeah, we have a photo of you here as a little girl.
That was my sister.
You and your sister, who passed away. Yes. When did she die?
She died. I was 5 and she was 3.
Wow, that must have been tough for you.
It was tough, and they didn't tell me what was going on, and I couldn't understand why they were putting Mabel in the ground.
Right. Just a little girl. It's hard to understand.
Yeah, they didn't tell you. They didn't explain things then like they do today.
No, my mom died when I was 10, and they didn't tell me either.
I know what you mean.
They said that she passed away, and I didn't understand what that meant. Yeah, it's a very tough thing.
It sure is.
Yeah. Now, I understand that you're not really a big drinker.
Oh, no. I was drunk one time.
You were? One time?
One time.
When was that?
Well, my husband and I moved to Indianapolis, and he said to me one day, Gladus, let's go have a highball. And I said, I don't want a highball. He said, oh, well, just get one. And I got drunk, and they had to put me to bed.
Really?
When I woke up, I was asking for ham sandwiches.
When you woke up?
I was asking for ham sandwiches.
No, I'm kidding. That's the Gladys Wagner hangover method. Ham sandwiches, ladies, if you want to know. What was it like for you as a child in 1904? What, with no electricity in the
no
house?
No electricity, no outside toilets. I mean, we had an outside toilet. We had to pump our own water, carry food from the basement, or from the cellar, we called them. It was out in the yard, cellar. And we had our own chickens and own cows and own hogs. Dad butchered two or three hogs a year, and we always butchered one cow. We always had lots of food.
Right, lots of stuff to eat.
Lots of food.
Now, what do you have plans for the new year, for the millennium, or do you have any big plans?
I don't have any plans. Just live it as it comes.
That's right. That's a good method for life.
That's the only thing you can do.
Live it as it comes. How long you plan on working at McDonald's?
Until I'm 100.
Till you're 100. Have you ever been to New York before?
No, I haven't.
You haven't?
I've enjoyed it very much.
Did you get to see any plays?
No, we haven't.
Would you like to see a play?
I sure would.
All right, how about Ragtime?
Anytime.
You know why it would be great for you? It's what life was like at the turn of the century.
Oh, that'd be wonderful.
I think that you would really enjoy that, Gladys.
Sure would.
And then you get to go out to dinner.
Good.
On us.
Good.
It's a wonderful play.
That's good.
It's delightful to have you here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for coming.
I appreciate it so much, more than you know.
Well, I'm glad for that. Gladys Wagner, we'll be right back after this break. Our next guest will really put a smile on your face. This is her debut CD, and here she is, Vitamin C. Woo!
Check. All right. First of all, when you wake up in the evening and the day is shot, find yourself complaining about the things you ain't got. Never goes just the way that you want it to. Cliche of the day, say la vie, that's just life. Life, it ain't easy. It's so tough.
What you gonna do, say, what you gonna do?
Put a smile on your face.
All right.
Make the world a better place. You get what you give in this life that we live, and all that you do will come back to you. Life,
life,
it ain't easy. It's so tough.
Life,
it ain't easy.
What you gonna do? So what you gonna do?
Put a smile on your face.
I'm life and everything nice. Love all your elders, please be polite. Even when you're hurting, don't forget to smile. Give love to our nation, big or small. When you do good, you'll get your reward. United we stand, divided we fall. Put a smile on your face and greet one and all.
Life, it ain't easy. Oh, it's so tough.
Life,
it ain't easy.
What you gonna do, so what you gonna do?
Put a smile on your face.
Come on, smile!
Put a smile on your face.
What you gonna do? So what you gonna do?
Put a smile.
Rasta know we are wishing you. Sure. You could have come from Jamaica or Honolulu. Hey. Keep a smile on your face and see the good that you do. Well, let's say you could do. Smile.
Wonderful job. Vitamin C and Lady Saw. We'll be right back after this. Don't go away. I just want to say, I hope you have a great day. Look what Gloria gave us to put up on eBay. This is Gloria and a photo when her entire staff, when she was in concert, dressed up like her. Men, women, her son, and walked on stage and they took this photo. That's Tony, her trainer. Now he's totally embarrassed. But that's him right there. If you live in Miami, can you believe it? That's him. This is going to be up on eBay.com. All the money raised this month will go to help fight breast cancer. Just remember, if you want a pizza...